Hello, John Talley here with Boats.net. Today I'm going to walk you through the process to replace our input shaft seals on our 40 horsepower Mercury tracker. It's not that tough to do, but before we get started, let's look at the parts I'm going to use to pull this off. What I decided to do here was, instead of just ordering the specific parts that we're going to do on this particular project, I went ahead and ordered a seal kit that has everything that you would need, no matter which part of your lower unit is leaking. So now that we've got our parts together, let's go over there and knock it out. First thing we need to do is remove the housing. Now it's just held in basically by the O-ring, so we can do this with a pair of vice grips or a pair of channel lock pliers. With that done, now it's time to just drive out the seals. Once the seals are driven out, we need to clean up the housing and then inspect it to make sure it's not damaged or corroded to the point it's not going to seal back up. Now let's get those new seals driven in. Next, we're going to take the neoprene seal, and it actually faces out, and just press it in until she bottoms. Go ahead and replace the O-ring and put a little bit of grease in between the seals and the O-ring. Now the entire assembly or housing can just be pressed back into position. As part of this particular kit I used, they gave a new shifter sleeve, and now is a perfect time to go ahead and replace it, especially if yours is old and cracked. Really easy to do. Well, all right, guys, that's going to wrap this one up. The only thing I have to do now is just, well, remount it to the power head. And if you need help doing that, if you would, reference this unit's playlist, and I can walk you through it. Well, if you need any of these parts or anything else for your machine, why don't you come see us at Boats.net, and we can get you taken care of. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the section below, and I'll do my best to answer them. And hey, you like what you see? Why don't you go ahead and hit that subscribe button? That way you can keep up with whatever I'm working on next. We just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at Boats.net, and we will see you in the next video. Y'all have a great day.